Welcome to Analytics with Nux. In our previous video, we have seen about how to install Power BI Desktop. In this video, we are going to see how to create your first dashboard in minutes. Let's explore it by having an example. A guy is owning a garment shop and he used to sell men's casual and ladies' casual. And he also sells some kind of accessories. So considering these facts, what things he is going to analyze and how he is going to create the dashboard from this, how he is going to benefit it. That's what we are going to see. Let's jump into a demo. So yesterday we installed the Power BI Desktop, and when you see it's empty, nothing is there. And there is a fields, visuals, filters, everything we are going to see quickly. And to get a report or to create a report, we need to have a data. So get data, and we have many options. Let's click on more. As explained previously, we can connect to 80 plus sources, and in your left hand side you see like different categories of data. If it's file, you can connect to these different file data. If it's a database, then you can connect to different database providers. And also there is Azure, online services. So there are n number of sources you can connect to. And based on the scenario, we will connect to either one of them or 5 to 6 sources. It's not all the data sources any business can connect to. So in this case, he will connect to Excel for customer data and database for point of sales. In this example, we will stick to Excel. Let's begin with this. So, we have sales data. Navigate to this. Once you navigate, you get the data here. It's a sheet name. You want to preview it, just click on it. And you can see the fields, the sale date, receipt number, order type name, whether it's on shop or order online. Maybe he owns a website. And from there, and there is an item name, jeans, Levi's, denim. We have a category, whether it's a casual, formal, selling price, item quantity, item amount, and tax amount, if it is applicable. So with this information, we can see that whether it's the data is correct or not. Those kind of checks we can check. Once we ensure, just check this checkbox, then click on load. So it will create a connection, then load the data. Once the data is loaded, you can see the list of fields, whatever you saw previous screen at the fields tab. Here, these are called metadata. Then the visualization, whatever visualization you have, different visualizations, you can create it here based on the fields provided here. Let's explore by creating one bar chart. We can maximize it, resize it. I'm going to see the item amount. Just go to the item amount and click on the checkbox. So immediately the data will be reflected in the graph, where there is a total of 9,86,650 rupees. So people don't want to see as a whole. And this amount is total amount from the day he started this business. So when I want to split this amount by item name, just go to the item name and click on it. So immediately my chart is reflected with split of item. And I want to increase the size slightly. I can focus mode, so I can see this chart clearly. And Jean Slivis is 2,54,000. And I don't want to display that labels here. I don't want to go and tooltip it. I mean, only if it, I don't want to see it in a tooltip. Instead, I want to expand. So the K item, I don't want to see. So I can choose that option. Then it will become the whole number, the actual figures. So like this, a lot of formattings are there. We will see it in future videos. Now I just want to see the overall total. For that, I going for data card. Item amount. This is the data card. This is used to see one particular measure or the numerical quantity I want to analyze. So along with this, I want to see the item quantity, how much total items sold in my shop. So there are 1,123 items sold in my shop. This is overall, okay? Overall, these many items sold in that shop. So when we have this information, usually we want to see the trend. So let us explore it by having the bar chart. Click on that column chart and click on date. And item amount. I'm getting the year wise hierarchy. I don't want it. I'm removing it. I want to see only by date. Now you see some dates are missing. It is randomly picking up. I want all the dates to be displayed. So for that, I need to replace with categories. I need to choose that option to have all the values displayed. And what else we can analyze is like, I want to have whether it's online or offline, how much amount sold. So for that, I'm going for pie chart. So it's like order type, item amount. Okay guys, so within few clicks, we can able to create multiple graphs along with the beautiful information. So I just want to have quick formatting so that it will look a little better. I change the background of the page. there are a lot of other formattings. We will see it in future videos, how to do all other formattings. So that's all guys. So we have created our first dashboard within 10 minutes. I hope you guys like the video. Please do subscribe this channel and do remember that data is your asset.